Yep. Very good. All right. So in we go. Feet shoulder width. Nice big hoop. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, and three. Reaching over. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, and raising the arms, gently stretching. One, two, three. To your right, two, three. To the left, two, three. Middle once, inhale, and exhale.
Very good.
Yep. Yeah. One, two, three. Right, two, three. Left, two, three. Middle once, inhale, and exhale.
Very good.
Hands on the waist, rotation. One, two, three, four. Eight, nine, ten, one, and two. Switch. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, one, and two. Crossing the hands, knees, gentle circle. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, one, and two. We switch hands, switch directions. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, one, and two. Hands on the waist, tilt the head side to side. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, one, and two. Back and forth. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, one, and two. Tilting. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, one, and two. Rotation, looking all the way around. One, two, three. When we switch, one, two, and three. Opening up the feet, arms out, turning the waist. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, one, two, three, and four. Great. So now we're going to step out with our, sorry, I'm going to go conventional view here. So we're going to step out with our right foot to the side. We want to be in an empty stance. Because we're going to pivot side to side, we want to step to the side, otherwise it'll be harder to kind of keep the reference. So we're going to go forward, back, forward, back. We pivot, shift, pivot, forward, back, forward, back. Pivot, shift, pivot, forward, back, forward, back. Pivot, shift, pivot, forward, back, forward, and back. Very good. Deep breathing. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Now we'll put the hands on the waist. Shoulder rolls going back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1 and 2. We go forward. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1 and 2. Now we're going to do arm swings. We inhale and exhale. Good. Deep breathing. Palms up. Elbows down. Elbows out. We inhale and exhale. And again, palms up. Elbows down. Elbows out. We inhale and exhale. One more time. Inhale and exhale. Good. We're going to make a circle with the wrist. This one, we're coming up the center and over to the sides. And let's switch directions, come up over the top and down the middle. Very good. Both palms down. We're going to make a big circle starting to the right. 1, 2, and vertical up. And we switch. 1, 2, vertical up. 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 And 1, 2, vertical up. Very good. Now we do both palms face down. We're going to bend the knees. We want to shift gently to the left. Lift up. Bring the right foot in. Out. In. Out. Shift. Lift. Bring the left foot in. Out. In. Out. Shift. Lift. In. Out. In. Out, shift, lift, in, out, and in. Very good. So now we're going to put our left foot back. I'm going to move the chair back. So we'll put our left foot back and our left hand forward, and we're going to swing. So we switch feet and hands. They counterbalance each other. Good. As a reminder, it does help your balance if you bend the knee of the supporting leg. So our, if this leg is locked straight, any movement from here goes straight through the hip, so it affects your body's position. If you bend the knee slightly, it's kind of like a shock absorber, and you can see that my body, my torso, stays fairly still. Good. Good, let's switch and put all our weight on our left. Touching with the right, right hand forward, and we swing. So if we do get the signal crossed, which can definitely happen, we want to just reset by putting the foot back and the hand on the same side forward as our starting position, and then we go. Back, the hand forward on the same side, and then we go. Excellent. Very good. All right, so now we're going to try to the side. We're going to put all our weight on the right leg, lightly touching to the side with the left. Again, one of the things that we want to try to do, and this isn't necessarily an easy thing to do, but we don't want to put weight on the foot that's in motion at any time. So when I get to here, I don't want to land on it. And then when I get to here, I don't want to land on it. I want to be lightly touching with all the weight here. Because if I end up landing on this, before I can move it, I have to shift the weight off again. So it requires all this body movement that can really upset our balance. If I'm able to lightly touch and lightly touch, you can see that it happens whenever I want to move that foot, I can move that foot because I don't have to unweight from that foot, right? So we'll try, we'll put the left foot out to the side, both hands to the right, and we come in, out, in, out, in, out, in, out, in, out. In, out, in, and out. Very good. Let's try the other side. Lightly touch with the right, both hands to the left. Come across as you come in, out, 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 in, and out. Very good. Take it out, keep breathing. Okay, so the next one, we're gonna step straight out the side with the left foot. So our right foot should be facing the front of the class. And for those at home, your right foot should be facing the camera. And your left foot should be facing the wall at the left, right? And again, if you use even the tiles or if you have floorboards at home or a pattern in the carpet, you can use any of that to help reference. The first thing we do when we go to step out is we touch the left foot to the heel of the right. That sets the starting position. And then from there, I want to make sure that I don't do this. This is the most common thing that happens when we go to step out to that empty stance. And it makes sense because I've done that demonstration before where I clamp this foot around, take all my weight off, my body wants to go there. So if I do this, take all of my weight and put it on this foot that's facing this way, or to turn this way if I let it, but I want to kind of control that and step straight out. Yep, so actually reverse the one in front facing the front of the class. Yep. Then touch the arch of your left foot to the heel, but you see how your foot's going to the corner, you want that foot to face towards almost. So you want this foot to face dead center that way. Yep, you got it. It's like a 90 degree T. Yep. And so from here we step out and now step that way. There you go. Okay, so now we're gonna shift, turn, sit back. Turn, shift, turn, sit back, turn. One more time, shift, turn, sit back, and turn. Good. So with our weight on the right leg, we sit back, the right hand to the shoulder, left hand to the hip. We're going to shift, left hand comes up, right hand comes down, turn, left hand comes down. Right hand to the shoulder, sit back, left hand to the hip. Shift to the left, lift the left. Draw down with the right, turn, draw down with the left. Right hand to the shoulders, sit back, left hand to the hip, shift, lift, draw down, turn, draw down. Right hand to the shoulder, left hand to the hip, shift, lift, draw down, turn, draw down, right hand to the shoulder, left hand to the hip, shift, lift, draw down, turn, draw down. Very good, let's try the other side. So now the left foot is gonna face right to the front, arch of the right foot to the heel of the left foot, and now we step straight out. Yep. So now we're gonna go shift, turn, sit back, turn, shift, turn, sit back, turn, shift, turn, sit back, and turn. Left hand to the shoulder, right hand to the hip, shift, lift with the right, draw down with the left, turn, draw down with the right. Left hand to the shoulder, sit back, right hand to the hip, shift to the right, lift to the right, draw down with the left, turn, draw down with the right. Left hand to the shoulder, right hand to the hip, shift, lift with the right, draw down with the left, turn, draw down with the right. Now this information might help you to keep it straight, or it might just be more information on top of the cacophony of instructions you already have. No matter which sign I put my hands, which orientation I go, whether it's my right hand to my left shoulder or my left hand to my right shoulder, if I'm shifting to my left side, it's the left hand that comes up. If I'm shifting to my right, it's the right hand that comes up. So that can help to kind of untangle the knot once it gets tied a little bit. Right? The other thing is that the hand that goes, that's up comes down and the hand that's down comes up. So the hand at the shoulder is not going to be the hand that goes up. It's already up. So it's going to come down. The hand that's at the hip, that's a lower position, that's going to come up. So when you're listening to the instructions of it and you see me in mirror image, that can cause a kind of a short circuit of, you know, what's what, because your brain's trying to figure out based on what it sees me doing right and left in the mirror version with the arms crossed. So it's almost easier to say, okay, I know I'm shifting to the right. My right hand is the one that's gonna come up because I'm going to the right. I'm gonna start with the right hand low, because it has to go from low to high. Right, now this is all a lot of conversation to have with yourself and may, you know, forget the details. But the more that we reinforce these things, hopefully the more that they'll kind of stick, because that's what we're trying to do. Good. Very good. Okay. So next, we're going to lightly touch with the left toe. You can also do this in a seated position, or you can do this standing, just keep shoulder width. It depends on what kind of state you're having, right? Now we're going to cross the wrist, vertical elbow, right? We call this a vertical elbow position because this is largely straight up and down, even though there's an angle to it. We're going to lift the elbows to horizontal. We're going to extend the left hand to the front and turn to the corner. We're going to drop the elbows, turn to the front. Lift the elbows, extend the left hand to the front, turn to the corner. Drop the elbows, turn to the front. Lift the elbows, extend the left hand to the front, turn to the corner. Drop the elbows, turn to the front. Lift the elbows, extend the left hand to the front, turn to the corner. Drop the elbows, turn to the front. Good. So just one other thing to add to that is that where we focus our gaze, if we turn our head to the side, we're much more likely to overreach with the hand that goes to the side, because our brain can't believe that all our hand is going to do is go from here to here. It thinks, well, that must push out that way. I'm looking that way. That's the way to go. And so when we're here and we go horizontal, if we can keep the head facing the front, you can still see both of your hands in your peripheral vision. If you lose sight of one of your hands, it's because you've moved the hand too much versus the body. So that's another way to kind of tell if you're staying on track. So when we lift, we extend this hand forward, we turn to the corner of the head space facing the front. We drop the elbows, turn back to the front. We lift the elbows, head space facing the front. Good. Drop the elbows, turn to the front. Peripheral vision is a very good way to tell whether we're using too much arm, because in most cases we're not going to turn the body more than 45 degrees to the reference of our own body. So basically I'm not typically going to turn this much. If I need to get to this side, I'll turn 45, but I'll also toe out. And then I face that way. So I make up the difference if I want to go more than 40 with the footwork. So since I'm going to turn not more than 45, you can see peripherally greater than a 45 degree angle. In fact, you can most likely see within 180. Anything past 180, it becomes harder to see. Right? So if you're even a little bit inside of 180, you should be able to see both hands without having to turn or to look at one and then the other. If you're looking at one hand, you totally lose sight of the other. Right? If I do this, I'm looking here, I can't see the other one. When I look to here, I lose sight of this one. So being able to gaze in a direction, you keep your head facing the front, but you can still see both hands. If I can't, I know I'm probably doing too much of this. Okay, so let's try the other side. Lightly touching with the right, cross with the right hand in front, vertical elbow. Lift the elbows, extend the right hand to the front, and turn to the corner. Head stays facing the front, and drop the elbows to the front. Lift the elbows, open. Drop the elbows, close. Lift the elbows, open. Drop the elbows, close. Lift the elbows, open. Drop the elbows, close. Very good. Okay, feet shoulder width, we're gonna do preparation. So we take some complicated ones and we kind of bookend it with something that's a little more simple. Lift, draw down and settle. And we repeat this one. Very good. We're going to go low hoop. Elbows are out. Everything relaxed. We breathe deeply and gently. Good. Shoulder height with that same hoop. You feel extra tension in the shoulders. Try to focus on relaxing that area. We drop the elbows, hold in a small ball. Elbows out, we bring the palms face down, straighten your arms, your legs, and your spine. Straighten the wrist, fingers towards the floor, arms just drape off the shoulders. Good, deep breathing. Excellent. So are there any questions so far? Any of that that's, you know, sometimes there are little technical things that we feel maybe not 100% clear with, and sometimes just all of Tai Chi feels like we're not clear on it. That's okay too. But is there anything while we're doing all of that that you have a difficult time with? Not so much. Okay. Good. If you do, just let me know. Not a problem. All right. So again, we're going to go to that kind of empty stance. We're going to step out. And this can still be done in the seated position. Nice. That was a great reference there. So by the way, one of the reasons that we touch the foot to the other foot as a reference is because you don't have to see it to know where you are. Right? If I want to step in a straight line from this heel, if I touch this heel, then I step out. If you think of it, if you're in a dark room and you're feeling your way around, if you can't touch a wall or a piece of furniture or something, you have no reference of where you are. But as soon as you get to like, okay, there's the nightstand, and all right, here I can follow along, here's the wall, here's the light switch, you can kind of find your way. And this is a very similar thing. We set that reference of touch. We touch the heel with, okay, now I know I can step out. Yeah, that's good. So we're going to bring the right hand to the shoulder, left hand to the hip. We're going to shift, open, sit back, reset. 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 Shift, open, and sit back, reset. Very good. Looking at this stage, I'm going to have to ask them for a brewmaster. So we have a little gazebo that we've kind of tried to extend the outdoor season, a little propane heater and stuff. And in that windstorm over the weekend, I came out and it was folded up in all of the wrong shapes. So I was in the front yard cutting it up into pieces. So anyway, we're going to step out with the right foot. Good. Left hand to the shoulder, right hand to the hip. Open. Sit back. Reset. Shift. 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 Open. Sit back. Reset. Awesome. One thing I do want to mention, because there are times during the class, whether it's because we have fatigue or maybe we have, I remember you had foot surgery and so maybe that bothers you, or we're just feeling like maybe we're having an off balance day, whatever it is, I want to do the exercises in a seated position. I fully encourage that. I think that's great. The alternative is like, well, I'm just going to, check out at that time. So when we do sit in a chair, if you're able to turn the chair to the side so you can see, but if you're able to, you want to try to kind of scoot forward a little bit to the front edge of the chair so that your back can be straight and support the weight of your body, your torso, and you can kind of have a better connection to the floor. If I lean back into the back of the chair, you notice that I don't have that same connection to the floor, right? The other thing is, it's a lot harder to turn your waist fully with your back against the chair. Even if I'm straight up and down, there's a kind of restriction created by the chair. But if I'm able to scoot forward, if you're at home and you have a chair with wheels, just be careful doing that because you don't want the thing to shoot out from under you. That's happened, okay? So there's a real concern addressed from those with experience, right? But yeah, but even that being said, even a chair with wheels, if I'm able to keep my spine straight, I'm at less risk of doing that. If I lean forward, it can go, right? So even if we're talking about the most fundamental exercises we do, things like this, when I'm in a seated position here, I'm actually getting a ton of benefit out of this, right? All of the things that we gain when it comes to balance on our feet, that kind of reinvigorating the connection of the nerve endings from the bottom of the feet into the brain, because there's a connection to the ground, those aren't lost because I'm in a seated position here, right? The ability to turn the waist and the mobility that we get in the lower back from being able to do that is enhanced. So all of these things, again, I'm 100% in favor of doing these things in a chair whenever you feel like that's something you want to do. And just try to be mindful of the back of the chair if you can, just so that if you're going to do those in a seated position, you can still get kind of a maximum benefit out of it. Because again, compared to no movement, this is still awesome, right? But this is better, right? And so we're trying to improve in increments, and that's just something to keep in mind. The last thing is, if you happen to have an armrest on your chair. You notice some of the chairs here don't have an armrest. But if you're at home and you're doing it, you can always put one hand here instead of putting it on the hip so that you're not kind of in your own way. And then when you're doing things like this, you still have that kind of mobility. Okay. So, okay, that's a quick chair spiel. So, have we done the other side? I think we've done both. So we're going to go feet shoulder width. Again, bending the knees slightly. Both palms facing down. We're going to pick up the right hand and turn to the right corner. Put it down, pick up the left and turn to the left corner. Put it down, pick up the right, turn to the right. Put it down, turn to the left. Down to the right. Down to the left. Down to the right. And down to the left. Very good. So all in all, this is done pretty well by everyone in the class. And it is still a bit to coordinate. Just one thing I want to mention, when we're doing these circles, whether it's this way or this way, you notice that the hands don't come a lot higher than the shoulder. And this is exactly the same circle that we're doing. It's just an alternate timing. And so we don't want to pick the hand up here for cloud hands because this kind of brings us out of position. So we want to maintain that size. When we lift the hand, it's not a lot higher than the shoulder. It's about that height. So that kind of creates a consistency in the size of that circle. We reference our own body for the height of that hand position. Very good. Let's make the low hoop again. This time we lift, palms out, drop the elbows cross, low hoop. Lift, palms out, drop the elbows cross, low hoop. Lift, palms out, drop the elbows cross, low hoop, lift, palms out, drop the elbows cross, and low hoop. Very good. Shoulder height, turn the palms out, figure eight, in and out. Very good. Very good. Palms up, waist high. Elbows out, we form a circle. Gather the fists and extend. Palms up, form a circle. Gather the fists and extend. Palms up, form a circle. Gather, extend. Palms up, form a circle. Gather, extend. Palms up, form a circle. Gather, extend, palms up, form the circle, gather, and extend. Very good. Neutral position. We're going to maintain the center as we draw down with the right hand and come back around. Draw down with the left and around. Draw down with the right and around. Draw down with the left and around. Draw down with the right. And draw down with the left and around. Very good. Horizontal elbow with the right palm. So the thumb is facing up, left palm against the right palm, and we gently alternate. Good. Very good. Let's switch, round out with the left, palm against palm, and we alternate. Very good. Back to neutral. We're going to turn to the right and back to the center. Good. We turn to the left and back to the center. This is drawing the bow. We turn towards the right and back to center, turn towards the left and back to center. Very good. Now we open up the feet, toes out. We're going to cross in the middle, lift up, make a big circle. Good. Cross, lift, big circle, cross, lift, big circle, cross, lift, big circle. Awesome. So that cross lift big circle, we're kind of automating that, right? No one has any issue so far doing that. When we turn, we can sometimes get confused, but the idea is, since we know how to cross lift big circle, we're going to try to put that element of it on autopilot and really just focus on the turn. So we turn to the right corner, cross lift big circle, turn back to the middle, good. Turn to the left corner, cross lift big circle, turn to the middle, good. Turn to the right, cross lift, turn to the middle. Turn to the left, cross lift, turn to the middle. Turn to the right, cross lift, turn to the middle. Turn to the left, cross lift, turn to the middle. Very good. Feet shoulder width. We're going to cross arms, right hand in front. Lift the right hand as we cross with the left. Switch. 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 And switch. Very good. Deep breathing. Very good. Awesome. So, any questions? Yeah. Okay, no worries. By the way, whenever I ask that question, there's no pressure on my end. Like, I'm not like, oh, they don't have a question. You know, if you have a question, that's great. If you don't have a question, not at all. So what I'd like to do is, let's go through the kind of the linear version of the form from the beginning to the end of the first section. So what that means is, without the legs, because the mapping of the footwork is another element to kind of keep track of and can be disorienting at first. So we're going to do this either in a standing or a fully seated position. I'm going to do mirror image to you, and we're going to go all the way up to the stork flap swing section of the form. Okay, so we're here, preparation. You draw down. Neutral position with the left hand on top. Horizontal elbow with the left, palm against palm. Now we alternate, diagonal flying. Good. Left hand comes to the center, then the right hand cycles over the top. So the left hand has to make room. So we're in that neutral position now with the right hand on top, good. Horizontal elbow, palm against palm. This is grass sparrow's tail. So we extend the right arm out, connect at the wrist, draw both hands diagonally down to the left hip. Left palm up, push your right hand to the right hip, lift the hand to the shoulder, and we go forward. Now, the one thing about this is that when we're doing this without the legs, we have a tendency to push out. But actually, once you get to here, that's really your position, because in the form, we use the legs to go forward versus straightening the arm. Right? So from here, hook the right hand, turn to the right corner. Now we turn the waist, opening up to that 45 degree position. Left hand comes to the middle and low loop. Right hand comes to the middle and high, holding the ball. We cross the wrist. The left hand that's underneath is going to come up. The right hand that's on top is going to come down. We have flying diagonally again. Left hand to the center. Right hand comes over the top. Horizontal elbow. Palm against palm. We're going to lift the right hand up. Bend it to the waist. Turn to your left. And come back up with a big hoop. Stork flap swing. Very good. So let's do that a couple of times. We're going to do that two times with narration and one time without. Or the one time without is going to be awesome. And then I can see the look of extreme confidence on everyone's face. It's inspiring. And then after we do that, then we're going to try to add the footwork to the mapping. Okay. So here we are. Preparation. Draw down, neutral position, left hand on top. Good. Horizontal elbow with the left, palm against palm. We're going to alternate. Draw down with your right hand, flying diagonal to the center, and right hand over the top. Extend out square, connect at the wrist. This is grasp the sparrow's tail. Draw diagonally down, left palm up. Push your right hand to the right hip, lift the hand to the shoulder. Good. Hook the right hand. We turn to the right corner. We come back to the left corner.
and low wing.
Left hand to the center and low. Right hand to the center and high. Cross at the wrist, left hand comes up, right hand comes down, flying diagonally. Left hand to the center, right hand over the top. Horizontal elbow, palm against palm. Raise the right hand as we press with the left, bend at the waist. Turn to the left and stand back up with both arms in a big loop. So let's try that one more time with narration and then one time without, and then we're going to add the legs. It's going to get crazy. All right. So here we go. Preparation. We draw down. Neutral position with the left hand on top. Horizontal elbow with the left, palm against palm. Alternate the elbow, draw diagonally down with your right hand, flying diagonally on the left hand side. Left hand to the middle, right hand comes over the top. Horizontal elbow, palm against palm. This is grass sparrow's tail. We have basically four movements. We extend out, connect at the wrist, draw down, flip, and extend out. Hook your right hand, turn to the right corner, come back with the left hand, single whip. Good. So we want the right hand, is even the hooked hand, the hand is about the height of the shoulder, and the left hand the same thing. And we go left hand to the middle and low, right hand to the center and high, holding the ball. Cross the wrist, left hand comes up, right hand comes down, left hand to the center, right hand over the top, horizontal elbow, palm against palm, raise the right hand, bend at the waist, back up, stored flat strings. That's really good. Okay. So does it start to feel like, I mean, first of all, there's no point when we're doing it without the legs and I'm facing you that you don't see which hand is doing what. So I think that can be useful. You know, from previous classes when we're in class together, when we start the form and I have my back to you, you couldn't see that. You could kind of see a piece of this depending on where you are in the class. If you're on that side, you can't see any of it, and maybe see some of what's happening here. Now here you can't see that hand transition. So this is one of the reasons why we do it this way. It helps to kind of just reinforce what's happening. The more we've seen it and we can confirm for ourselves, yeah, we made it through that a few times, feel a little more confident as you go, can be useful. All right, so speaking of confidence, this time we're going to do it without narration. I'm going to go by the Marine Tai Chi code, which is we leave no man nor woman behind. So I will pause at each posture and wait until everybody's on the same page. And if you have a question, please ask it at that time. And otherwise, we'll just continue through. So here we are, begin. Good. Nice. Yep, you got it. Good. Very good. Nicely done. Good. So the right hand's on top, no worries. We cross our hands with the right hand on top. Yeah. And now the left hand comes up, the right hand comes down. Good. Nice. Excellent. Yeah, that was really good. Any questions or thoughts on all that? No? Okay, let me just quickly check time. I think we're pretty good. Time, great. So let's do it even one more time without narration exactly as we just did it. And then we can add the actual footwork that we use in the form. Okay? So we're ready and we begin. Good. We're done. Good. Yeah, really nicely done. Okay, so we're going to do the same thing. I'm going to do narration because I have to narrate also the footwork, but also because we're giving ourselves a different look on what we were just doing, it's very easy to get lost in that if we don't have narration. So we're going to start at least with narration. Okay? So let's see. I'm going to do mirror image one time, and then I'll do conventional view the next, just in case mirror image causes a problem. We have preparation, draw down, good. Shift to your left, pivot on the right, shift to your right again, touch the toe, there's our reference to the heel, we step out, empty stance, neutral position with the left hand on top, horizontal elbow, palm against palm, we shift forward. Now on this one, we sit back, but we keep the foot flat, and we kick our left heel out, shift to the left leg, alternate the elbow, draw diagonally down with the right hand. Good. We step up, step in, touching the toe as a reference, step out with the right, right hand on top. Now we do grass as far as tail, horizontal elbow, palm against palm. We go forward, extend, connect with the wrist, sit back. We draw both hands down to the left hip, left palm up, push your right hand to the right hip, lift the hand to the shoulder, and we go forward. Sit back, hooking your right hand. Pivot to the front right corner, shift your weight to the right leg, feet together, step out with your left, pivot on the heel, come across with your left hand, single width, center and low with the left, center and high with the right. So just reverse the hands. Yep, you got it, nice. Now we're gonna shift to the left, pivot on the right heel, cross at the wrist, left hand comes up, right hand comes down. We step up, touch the toe, step straight towards the front. Left hand on top, right hand comes over the top. Just bring that foot that way a little so that you're not going to the corner, but you're going that way. There you go, good. Horizontal elbow with the right, palm against palm, we go forward. We step up, feet shoulder width. We're gonna raise the right hand, bend at the waist, turn to your left, and we come back up, across. There's a lot there, right? So in most cases, we're either going to face, we're typically our movements are going to take us as far as the footwork, the mapping of the feet. It's going to take us 90 degrees. So we're going to go this way, we're going to go this way, we're going to come back this way, we're going this way, going up, turning this way, right? We end up doing brush knee. Facing this way. There are a couple of oblique angles that we do with our footwork towards the end on the left-hand side, but for the most part, we're gonna end up going either this way, or that way, right? So if you find yourself, especially early in the form sequence, stepping to that front direction and you're not square to the direction you began, then you can know that that's something you wanna make an adjustment at, right? All right, so this time I'm going to do conventional view. I'm going to turn my back, and so I'll be on exactly the same side as I'm narrating. Okay? Okay, so we're here. Raise the arms, preparation, draw down, shift to the left, pivot on the right toe, shift to your right, touch the left toe, the left toe, and step out. Empty stance. Neutral position with the left hand on top. Horizontal elbow with the left, palm against palm, we shift forward. We sit back, kick our left heel out, the feet are parallel. We're gonna shift forward to the left leg, alternate the elbow, right elbow comes up, drawing diagonally down with the right hand. This is diagonal flying on the left side. You step up, bring the right foot in, step straight out neutral position. We're going to do grasp. Extend the right arm out, connect to the wrist. Draw both hands down to the left hip, left palm up, push your right hand to the right hip, lift the hand to the shoulder, and we go forward. We sit back, hooking the right hand, pivot on the heel to the corner, shift to the right leg, both feet together. We step straight out, pivot on the heel, and we come across, single whip. Center and low with the left hand, center and high, holding the ball with the right, shift to the left. Give it on the right heel, cross at the wrist, left hand comes up, right hand comes down, flying diagonal. We step up, step in, step out. Right hand on top, neutral position, horizontal elbow, palm against palm, we shift forward. We step up, feet, shoulder width. We raise the right hand, bend at the waist, turn to your left, and stand back up with the hoop, stork flaps wings. Nice. How did that one feel? Right, having built up to it with the facing without the legs and then doing the legs, but in your image, I didn't get any sense of great exasperation. Usually the spidey senses go in the back of the neck. I go, okay, there's a distress in the room, but today was pretty subtle, right?
Lucy?
Okay. Sorry, was there a question?
Yes. Could we see you do that and you do it yourself, what it looks like when you know what you're doing?
Sure. Did you want to see that mirror image, like facing camera, or the way I just did it, conventional view?
Mirror image, because I couldn't follow at all when you were facing the other way.
Gotcha. Okay. So if you guys didn't hear the request online from Kathleen, was that we're going to do, she wants to just see me do it. Kevin, do you want to see that done just regular, you know, kind of regular tempo like we do in class? Or do you want to see a more continuous version, whatever you prefer?
I wanted to see a continuous, what it looks like, to give us a picture of what it looks like.
Okay, so I'll try to add a little kind of rounding out of the corner. So here we go. We have preparation. Yeah. Left foot forward. Beginning style, flying diagonally, grasp the sparrow's tail, single whip, hold the ball, flying diagonally, beginning style, step up to raise the hand, and stork flap swing. Did that help?
Yes, it did. Thank you very much. It helps to see it all in our
thing. That raises an issue that often comes up, especially some of you have been. That's awesome. And the question often comes up because what I teach in class is the block version of the Tai Chi form, right? And so you notice it doesn't have that flowing, continuous feel that we might associate with Tai Chi. And the question always comes up, well, I've been doing this for a while. When do I start to make it smoother and add continuity? And how do I make that happen? And the answer is actually just keep doing the block version. Because what the block version offers us is an opportunity to pass through all of the positions within the form in a meaningful way. So again, I've used this analogy before, but I'll use it again. If I told you, I'd like you to draw an arc on a piece of paper. I want you to do it by connecting dots, not just freehand, but I want you to place the dots and you make an arc. You can use as many dots as you want. If you use three dots, it's not going to be a very smooth arc, right? So the more points along the way, movement is, right? which might feel counterintuitive because you say, well, wait, I'm going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4. How does that smooth it out, right? And so the way that that smooths it out is that as I continue, but I don't miss any of those postures, in the upper and the lower was where it needed to be, objectively speaking, obviously, but so that's how we kind of smooth things out. We go through each individual part enough that the body begins to recognize it, right? It's kind of like doing these circles here, right? A lot of people pick up on the fact that when we do this, that there's a coordination between my elbows and my knees, my wrist and my ankles, my shoulder and my hip, right? When we try to do this, sometimes it ends up kind of forced. We end up kind of, right? But if we don't worry about that and we just worry about the structure and the kind of function of what we're trying to do, okay, we don't want the hands bigger, higher than the shoulders, that determines the size. We come up the middle, turn the palms out, and then come down the side. If we relax the body and do that repeatedly, pretty soon the chest becomes involved. It's relaxed. If I'm really stiff, this movement doesn't translate to the rest of the body. But if I relax, pretty soon, you notice the torso is a little more involved. Next thing you know, the hip, then the knee. And ultimately, over time, in a way that's fairly natural, moves, you're coordinating your joints. They correspond to each other. Wrists to ankles, knees and shoulders. I mean, wrists and hips. That is actually how your body moves. If you wanted to jump over something, right, you could jump, right? But you're not going to get very far. But if you wanted to jump over something, you might launch yourself up. That's your ankles. As your ankles bend, your wrists are bending. As your knees bend, your elbows bend. And then you spring upward. Right? So this is how your body is to move. But we can often overthink like the things that we're trying to coordinate because there's so much instruction. There's so many details we're trying to hit. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Over time, then that turns into something with a little more nuance. Okay. So that's kind of what we're going for. I hope that was helpful to you at home, Captain. So in any case, I think we might sadly be at time. Yeah, we are. But anyway, thank you all for coming.